Oh, hello.
Hello.
What is your name?
My name is Elizabeth Roberts. I'm from Tucson, Arizona, and I majored in computer science at Yale, which is actually when all this started. Maybe in my senior year, I fractured my foot, and that just didn't heal, and it turned out that it was CRPS. And so I struggled with that for the end of college, and started working at a medical IT company, and I thought that I could work past this, and it ended up just being a much more difficult experience than I anticipated, and very difficult to treat.
And what was your experience with CRPS treatment?
Honestly, it's been lovely. The treatment has been easy enough, and obviously it's a little difficult for me to get around. People have been very helpful, very supportive, and I really appreciate that. And it hasn't been difficult. You know, it's actually been a lot easier than I expected it to be. And the stay here has been lovely. It's such a beautiful country, and it's the area around Potenza especially, and it's really great.
How did you get to know about the program and the Neurotrinate infusions in the first place?
I learned about the Neurotrinate from just doing research on the topic and just going through any scientific papers that were available on attempts to treat CRPS, because I'd had a number of treatments from a neurologist, neurosurgeon in Wisconsin, and then again a pain specialist in Tucson. And neither of them, they were familiar with the disease, but neither of them had any good options for treatment. They tried tons of things, so I was just keeping an eye on the papers, just trying to hear about anything, if there was anything that could possibly make a difference. And that's when I found the original paper in the Oxford Rheumatology Journal done by the Italian researchers, who had first shown that the neurotrinate was making a major difference in every single one of their patients. So from there, I tried to keep an eye on that. There were a couple of other treatments I still had to finish going through first, and I actually was able to participate in a trial of this in the US, but it was a safety trial, which I was not informed of, and they were using a very low dose, and I got half placebo anyway, and so nothing happened with that, and it was just basically a year wasted on hoping that I would get the full dose, which I didn't even realize they weren't giving. So. From then we started researching other ways to possibly try to get the full dose, you know, trying to get doctors in the US to prescribe it off-label, see if it's available in Mexico or Canada, and really the only thing we found was this program for Italy, and with everything, them handling all the coordination and sort of being an interface between the hospital and the hotel and everything else, so that you don't have to worry about language problems or anything like that, it seemed like the best option.
How were the infusions?
They were fine. Aside from a couple of times, a little bit of trouble getting the IV in, that's always been difficult to do with that. They've been pretty good. Honestly, I've slept through most of them. The others, you know, brought a book, a couple hours, relaxed in a nice chair. They were a lot easier than I expected.
Did you experience any side effects?
I did. Mostly I was just exhausted. It was worse the first couple of treatments, where I would come home and then just fall asleep for 8 hours immediately after and be awake for a couple hours and fall right back to sleep for the night. The first time I had some more side effects, sore throat, really aching all over, but just a day of Tylenol and that was fixed. So I hadn't noticed that through any of the other patients. So mostly just being tired.
Did you feel any immediate benefits in any way?
I don't think I have yet. It's hard to say because my pain varies so much from day to day. And I also had it for 5 years, so it's gotten to be quite severe and quite difficult to control. I mean, even with the morphine I usually take, it doesn't cut the pain you know, all the way or anything like that. But, so no, no immediate, no immediate effects. But I remember in those papers, they were, you know, most of them weren't seeing a whole lot of improvement until about 2 months anyway. So don't want to worry.
How was your accommodation?
It's been lovely. This hotel is fantastic. The breakfast is amazing, and it's probably caused me to gain at least 5 pounds. the rooms are nice. It gets a little warm, but I mean, it's late spring in Italy. It's going to happen. But it's been very comfortable, and the staff have been very accommodating. You know, we've had a little bit of difficulties with communication, but by and large, it's been great.
And how was Dr. Daniela Righetti instead?
She was wonderful. You know, talked with her a little bit at the end of each session, and quite a bit at the end of the last one. And she's clearly is very, very well informed, the best informed on this topic of any doctor I know. And she's very thorough. She does honestly really care too, and that's been great. And yeah, she's just really friendly, very professional, very competent, obviously. Just wonderful.
What was your experience with the nursing staff instead?
The nursing staff is pretty great. They're very supportive, and again, just coming in to check on things. Never, if the machine started beeping a bit, they'd be in there right away to see, make sure that everything's going smoothly. Like I said, a couple of times they had some trouble with the IV, but it was never that, not that big a deal, I think it was. So, yeah.
Is there any information you would like to share with your fellow CRPS patients in the United States and to the rest of the world? Would you recommend this treatment in any way?
You know, I definitely would. I can't say I have personal experience with it working yet, but it's the only thing in the studies that has a significant, statistically definitive improvement. And most of the studies, it helps everyone. And some people get complete remission, and not everyone does, but I remember reading a story about one person who had come here from the treatment. And for her, she had had very bad CRPS, probably at least as bad as mine is, in her foot as well. And then, you know, several months after the fact, she was like, yeah, I have to take Vicodin occasionally when I go running. It's just the thought of that's not even possible is just amazing. So, yeah. I recommend it just because, again, it does have the science behind it. And I met a woman here when I was getting my first treatment. It was her fourth day of treatment, and she was already showing really impressive progress. And she had CRPS in the hand, and she was, I just saw her grabbing things, helping things. She even took my wheelchair at one point to help me while people were busy. And I can't imagine doing that, and neither could she except for this. So that, more than anything else, is giving me hope for this.
Great. We also are providing, well, another treatment which we are testing, which should reduce the CRPS pain using light therapy. How did you react to this treatment which we proposed to you?
You know, I haven't been doing it long enough to give any definitive answer. I've done it for, I guess, 2 days now, and 1.5 to 2 days. So I haven't noticed improvement yet, but again, like I said, my pain also varies from day to day, so for all I know, this would have been a bad day, but now it feels better, I can't tell. It is somewhat painful, for me at least, but because you keep the light really close to your foot, and I guess it's probably the heat that's making it a bit uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
But it's certainly not a reason not to do it. If it can help, then you know, certainly not going to turn for that. So I'm going to keep trying it over the next few days and see how it goes.
Okay. Well, thank you, Elizabeth. We'll speak to you to follow up in 2 months' time. And I really hope you have a safe journey back and that this treatment will really help you.